When I was a toddler, my mom left me with my grandmother, with her mom. But she was an alcoholic and she was really sick. So she called my dad and my dad went pick me up. But he wasn't mature enough yet to be a dad and he left me with his parents, who actually end up raising me for 18 years. He wasn't a father figure. He was just someone else in my life. And I guess that's pretty much one of the biggest holes in my life. And every school activity, every school thing that they did, everyone had a mom and a dad, and I didn't. There was mom, there was a dad. Mine were not or anywhere to be found. I tried to look at positive, but I always had that void and that emptiness. Basically, I was in church my whole life. Even though I believed in God and I was really happy going to church, I did blame God. He was at fault. God created my mom and my dad. So as a child, was kind of like, okay, so you did all these good things, but you also made these two people. During my marriage, we experienced a lot of violence, a lot of abuse and whatnot. Even my kids were part of it. And it was really hard. It was moments that I wish I was dead. Even my kids, like, I wish for us to be dead rather than be living in that situation. Getting out of there wasn't easy, as we thought. We tried a couple times, but it was really hard. Until we finally found a way out. My kids were 1 and 4 at the time. I filed for divorce, we got out. But the abuse never ended because he had visitation rights. So even when he came to pick up the kids, he still did the same things, even to me. So it took us about 3 years after the divorce to get rid of him. And through all those years, that was the moment I really blamed God for everything. I didn't want to hear any word about God. I didn't want to hear anyone inviting me to church. I didn't want to hear anything. I started looking online for like free camps. Faith Church came up. It's a summer camp. It's not church. I did not want to do church. So we came. I actually stayed the first day sitting on that white couch downstairs. I didn't know how the kids were gonna react or anything, so I sat down from drop-off to pick-up time. Patty asked me if I wanted to help Joanne in the kitchen. I said, fine, I'll help her. So I did. Talking to Joanne in the kitchen was like, in a way that I can feel God inside, like in every word she said. But I hesitated. I was like, hell no. It's not gonna happen. That's not what I want. There was something inside of me. I don't know what it was. I cannot explain it. I felt like I needed to stay. I needed to be here. God spoke to me in so many ways that I cannot explain. Every person I spoke to said something, did something that hit home. That was my turning point. And since then, I came back every summer. And now I'm coming on Sundays and teaching on Sundays. Like every step I take, it's stronger than ever before. I want to make sure that I know, God knows, and everyone knows that God is my God, and I'm not going back. My name is Bridgewater, and I decided to follow Jesus.